like to thank the honor of this evening point and the staff at Marston House for hosting this event. We would also like to thank the province of BC for making this project possible with their generous contribution. Thank you also to the welcoming song and the welcome prayer. I'd also like to thank the Coast Salish people for welcoming us onto their territory today. And of course, we're here today to congratulate the four First Nations artists for the beautiful pieces that they have created for the enjoyment of everyone at this event and for all British Columbians for generations to come. The amount of skill, knowledge, and creativity that went into each of these pieces of art is truly outstanding. We're very proud of you and are excited to be here to commend your commitment to your communities, cultures, and artistic traditions. Your work demonstrates the important cultural knowledge that lives within the arts and connects each and every one of us to the vibrant cultural traditions that came before, while still reminding us that First Nations cultures are a living, breathing thing that will continue to evolve. We'd also like to acknowledge this project as an important act of reconciliation. Art can help bridge gaps, overcome barriers, and teach us new ways of seeing the world. This is an important part of the healing process that benefits both First Nations and non-First Nations people. Our mandate at the First Peoples Heritage Language and Culture Council is to assist BC First Nations in the preservation and revitalization of an Aboriginal language, culture, and artistic traditions. And it is through projects like this that our mandate is realized. It's been our great honor to facilitate this opportunity for these artists throughout the past year, and we look forward to continuing the work for BC First Nations, individuals, and communities in the future. While the revitalization of First Nations languages often gets a lot of attention, we must not forget that there is still much work to be done to ensure that First Nations art will also continue to thrive for future generations. Our elders are the keeper of our traditional knowledge, and they are passing away at an alarming rate. Unless their knowledge is transmitted to the next generation before it's too late, we will lose what these artistic and cultural practices represent, a reminder and exploration of our identities as proud First Nations people. These are incredibly experienced artists, for example, with unique skills and knowledge of artistic practices who cannot find apprentices. This is something that should concern every one of us. We must work together to ensure that future generations of artists have many opportunities to learn our traditional practices so that we can proudly live in the present and move forward into a more prosperous future. I'd like to now introduce my colleague and friend, Kathy Charles Weary. Kathy is the arts coordinator at the First Peoples Council, and she works tirelessly to connect artists, arts organizations, and arts administrators with the assistance that they need to grow and to develop. She's an artist, a curator, a writer, and an arts educator. It is through much of her hard work and dedication that this event is taking place. So please join me in thanking